In part two, chapter 13 of Madame Bovary, back at his estate, Rodolphe tries to write Emma a letter explaining himself. He pores over their old love letters, trying to remind himself why he loved her. They are mixed up with other letters from many other women, and Rodolphe grows bored reading through them, feeling that all these women are interchangeable. Finally, he writes to her that they would eventually grow weary of each other, and he is doing her a favor by not eloping with her. He also tells her that he's leaving without her. He hides the letter in a basket of apricots he has delivered to her home. Anxiously, reading Rodolphe's letter, she gazes at the ground below and considers jumping from her balcony. Her thoughts are interrupted by Charles calling to her. Emma returns to the kitchen, and Charles casually tells her that Rodolphe is gone. Outside, she hears his cart go by and falls from her chair in a faint. They bring her to bed, where she falls into a fever for 43 days, during which time Charles never leaves her bedside. She slowly gets better, but when she sees the bench where she used to meet Rodolphe in the garden, she grows ill again. Meanwhile, Charles begins to worry about the state of their finances. In part two, chapter 14 of Madame Bovary, Charles considers how much he owes Homais for all the medicine he's applied for Emma, and how their household expenses have risen now that the cook is in charge. He takes out a loan from Monsieur Leroux, who takes the opportunity to inflate the bill on the cloak and traveling trunk Emma ordered. Emma thinks everything she had once loved, she now disliked. She is visited often by the town priest and grows more religious. For the most part, she puts Rodolphe out of her mind and begins to dedicate herself to charity. But just as she seems to be moving on, things take a dramatic turn when she and Charles decide to visit the city of Rouen to see an opera. In part two, chapter 15 of Madame Bovary, Emma is enthralled by the opera and sees much of her own life and sorrows in the story and songs. During the intermission, Charles admits he did not understand the story at all. Returning from getting Emma a glass of water, he tells her he ran into Léon, who appears right behind him. The three of them go to a nearby cafe to catch up on their lives. Charles encourages Emma to see the opera once again and to stay in the city for the rest of the week.